Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So right now I am in Phoenix, Arizona or whatnot. A friend, she lives out here, and so I came to visit her. We plan on having fun this weekend. We literally just landed. The flight was late as fuck. I'm tired. My back hurts. Right now I'm waiting on my luggage. I'm waiting for my luggage, whatnot. And ooh, they have a Starbucks. Ooh. But yeah, I'm tired, y'all. Like, I'm off of like 2 hours of sleep. I literally packed everything this morning. So I hope I got everything, because if I didn't, oh well. But yeah, I'm ready. I'm excited. I'm probably going to talk to you guys again when I am in her car or whatnot, or probably when I get my luggage. I'm not too sure. But this weekend we do plan on going to see the Lil Baby concert, because Lil Baby and Chris Brown, he gonna be in Arizona. We also plan on, like, you know, just going out. I already know that, like, Phoenix is not like Houston, so I'm not expecting to be in the clubs, and you know, I'm not expecting it to be Houston vibes, but I still would like to have fun. And I feel like me and my friend, we make fun out of anything, okay? Okay. So it don't matter where we go, we gonna have fun. I'm excited to see her. I have not seen her in forever. I miss her. I miss her so much. And if you are watching this vlog, because I know you're gonna watch this vlog, because yeah, you watch all my videos, really, but your ass gonna be in it, so you're really gonna watch this vlog. I love you, Naomi. Kisses.
What y'all say? The vibe not ready yet.
All right, y'all, this my food. So I got some tacos. We at Torchy's Taco right now. About to eat. Y'all hungry?
I'm
bad, though. I am. Yum, yum, yum.
Wait, is vegan?
Yeah.
So why is that vegan?
That's avocado fried.
Oh.
Yeah. Not bad. Whenever I get Torchy's, my shit be hot.
The taste is
I can't eat Torchy's, and that's why I say I'm happy I didn't get it, because I don't know if I would have wanted to eat it today. Yeah. We can go on dates with your nigga.
Yeah.
You eat like that?
Yep.
Surprised you haven't broke up with her yet.
This is not bad.
If y'all see the way this bitch eat.
Come as you are. Stop.
I'm gonna be real. If I was a nigga and me and Naomi went on a date and Naomi is there eating like that, I'm never calling Naomi again. She has a nice nigga shot. He probably overlooks it. But I'm telling you, he don't like it. Cause I'm not even gonna lie to y'all, though. I don't eat good either. I always have some type of food on my shirt by the end of it all. The funny thing with Naomi is Naomi eats messy, but her clothes will be fine. I eat messy, and you gonna know I ate by the time I get to eat it. I always have some type of food on me. Let me tilt the camera, because I don't want this young man to be like, why does she have me in her video, blah, blah, blah. The boy in the back, I don't want him in the camera. Yeah. Yeah. You know, people just don't like being recorded. I told you, this one's not bad, but it ain't.
Yeah.
I've had better.
Me too, same.
This sauce is helping me.
Yeah.
It's all sweet.
Uh-huh.
You don't use that sauce?
No, I use
it. Oh.
Bro, she's still cleaning. Turn around slowly.
She's cleaning the cooker thing. That girl needs to get fired. That's exactly why I'm bad, bro. The lot was packed. This black girl was there cleaning menus. It's like, bro, you know that's not your job. Cheers.
Bye, bro.
Cheers, bro. Y'all better be on the other side of the camera clicking it with your cups. Cheers.
girls are amazing.
Let me give you all a recap about yesterday, right? So yesterday was good. Me and Naomi, we decided to go to the club or whatnot. Of course, you know, we didn't have a section because, yeah, it was just two of us. And so, you know, but the club was still good. Like, they play good music or whatnot. Y'all seen it. I recorded a little bit of it. I recorded a little bit. That's it. Let me tell y'all what we got planned today. So right now we're getting ready to go bowling. We wanted to do like a little small activity before we go to the concert. Today we are, hold on, I'm gonna set the camera up because I don't feel like holding it. Naomi, say hey.
I'm naked.
No, I'm saying just say hey. Okay. I'm trying to turn up the brightness for y'all, but like when I turn up the brightness, my hand go in slow motion. I don't know. Y'all know me. Y'all know I still don't know how to work this camera like that. But whatchamacallit, so basically we went out yesterday and it was very fun. We didn't have a section or whatnot, but let me tell you about these Arizona boys, because I gotta tell y'all, these Arizona boys, like, y'all see the palm of my motherfucking hand? Not this. They don't like this. I'm talking about the Arizona black boys. I'm not talking about just regular Arizona boys. I'm talking about the black boys. They like, What color is my hands on the inside? Mm-hmm. That's what they like. They like white girls. And it's very sad to see. And the way they flaunt these little white girls around, it's... And ain't nothing wrong with liking what you like, okay? If you have a preference and you like you some white girls, ain't nothing wrong with it, okay? But it was, like, actually baffling to see. Like, they actually really do like white girls. Well, I'm not really too shocked because we are in Arizona, you know what I mean? I'm not too shocked about it. It's I think Arizona, is Arizona not a predominantly white place, Naomi?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a predominantly white place. So if you grow up around, like, you know, white people your whole life, you eventually, you, whatever you grow up around, you eventually, that's what you gravitate towards. So I'm not really, like, surprised or anything, but they actually really do like white girls. So we were in this section, we were behind this section yesterday. The way the club was set up, it was like a section and then it was a pole. We were like behind the section. And it was a group of these black boys in the section. One of the boys in the section, he asked Naomi, do we want to drink a shot? Because we were just standing there. So we were like, yeah, shit, yeah. So he gave us cups. He gave Naomi a cup. He gave me a cup. So we're getting ready for him to, like, you know, pour the shot or whatnot. And then he tells us, oh, y'all come around, like, y'all come sit down in the section. So we're like, oh, okay. Y'all, tell me why we pulled up to the section. First of all, his homeboys is looking at us like, why are y'all here? I'm here. So at this point, we're just staring around like it's awkward as hell. The boy who told Naomi to come asked Naomi, does she want a drink? I had came to the section first. So he was telling me to tell Naomi that he wants her to sit. The way the section, y'all know how sections be set up with, like, tables and then y'all know with chairs. Y'all know you can sit on the regular chair or you can sit above the chair and have your feet planted on the chair. He was sitting above the chair. So there was space. There's like space for us to sit on below. He tries to say, like, oh, he wants her to sit. He wants her to sit in between him. I'm like, and so I'm just looking awkward. So I told Naomi, I'm like, he said sit in between you. That's what he told me right now. So Naomi's like, what? Like, what's the point of sitting in between? Like, she was so confused. She was like, what? That don't make sense. So we talking back and forth, but scratch that. Like, even the boy saying sit in between was, like, weird and all. But even then, the way the boys' friends was looking at us was awesome. Like, why are y'all here? Like, everyone was just staring at us like, no. And it is so weird because, like I told Naomi, I said, if a Houston nigga asks us to come to his section, his friends are going to get up for us to sit down. And, of course, they didn't have a lot of girls in the section, but the girls that they did have in the section were white. And so I don't know. I just feel like they don't really like black girls like that out here. Like, they really don't. Naomi, am I tripping or do they? Yeah, they don't like black girls out here. Like, they don't really like black girls. Cause like I said, bro, if it was, even if, like, let's say we were in Houston, right? And, like, a guy told us to come to the section, but he wasn't even in charge of the section. Let's say his friend was in charge and his friend seen us. And the Houston guy was like, oh, I invited them to the section. His friend would have been like, oh, y'all come in. Y'all sit. Y'all want a shot? He would have gave us a cup. He would have poured us a drink. Like, it would have been fine. He would have even gave us a tip to smoke the hookah type shit. Them niggas was looking at us like, why are y'all here? So at this point, we're like, hell no. Nah. Like, it's good. It's good, shot. Like, it's good. So we went back around. We're like, no, we were embarrassed. We were irritated. The boy who told us to come to the section is looking everywhere but in our face. So it makes us look stupid. It makes us look like we just wanted to run to a random section. Which I told Naomi before we got there, I said, hey, bro, we need to find a section because I did not just want to be standing in the middle of the aisle or whatnot. So I was like, hey, we need to find a section. We need to get cool with one of these niggas and find a section. Sorry. But it was so hard to do so because, first of all, them sections are small as hell and them sections was full. Like, that club was full. That club was packed out. All the sections were sold. But we ended up finding a little tiny section towards the end with some drunk girls and whatnot. And then, So at this point, we have the cup in our hand. We have the empty cup in our hand. Because remember, he was supposed to pour us a drink and he never did. So me and Naomi, we're irritated. We talking shit about him. We're like, the fuck? Like, why did this nigga do that? Like, that's weird, you know? So while me and Naomi are talking shit, I told Naomi, I said, well, I'm gonna give him the cup and say, you know what? I don't want, like, you know, take your fucking cup. Like, I don't want this shit no more. So I give him the cup and he's talking to me, but I can't really hear what he's saying. So I'm just telling him, like, nah, I don't want the cup. Like, just take it. So I see him take the cup and Naomi was like, he's pouring you a shot. And I was like, I didn't ask for a shot. I said, but okay, I didn't ask for a shot. So he pours me the shot, right? Y'all, tell me why, mind you, the boy's back is facing us. because we're behind their section. Tell me why this useless boy takes the drink and pretend I'm him, right? So I'm facing like this. Pretend y'all are behind me. He takes the cup and he goes like this. He doesn't look. It's like on some like he was feeding a pet. Bitch, I don't know whether he thought I was a dog, a monkey, a giraffe, a penguin, a flamingo, a roach, a mosquito. I don't know what he thought I was, but the way he gave me that cup, it's like he thought he was feeding a pet. Like, he didn't even look behind nothing. Like, he literally just gave me the cup, and then he just kept partying and shit like that. I was like, I said, Arizona niggas are different, bro. It's funny because it's like, I always complain about Houston niggas. I always complain about Houston niggas, bro. But a Houston nigga would not do that shit. Like, for real. Like, I know Houston niggas, they have a lot of flaws. They do a lot of shit that I don't like. But I know for a given fact that Houston nigga would have never done that. Like, it was just so weird. And me and Naomi were just like, what's wrong with this boy? Like, but yeah, that's what happened. But other than that, on a good note, the club was lit. Like, me and Naomi, we didn't have a section. We didn't find a section to the very end. And even then, that wasn't even a section because the girls were leaving or whatnot. So we basically stood. But the club was still lit. I was a little zooted. So it was kind of hard for me to concentrate. But I was still lit or whatnot. I'm trying to think. They play good music. They play some good-ass music or whatnot. And one thing I like about the people in Arizona, they be turning up. Like, sometimes when you go to the club in Houston, people be trying to do bottle wars, like, you know, pop bottles, you know, the scammers, they be trying to pop bottles. So, you know, in Houston, the club scene is sometimes turns into flexing. Like, people in the sections posted up, like, you know, trying to be prissy and shit, like, or trying to show off their drip and shit like that. It wasn't like that here. Like, everybody be turning up, the whole club be dancing, like, everybody be moving and shit. So I really, really like that. So the club was good or whatnot. And yeah, I'm just ready to go to the concert. So yeah, like I told you guys before, we're about to go bowling. And then after we go bowling, I'm probably gonna come home. And then, well, we are gonna come home. And then we're gonna get ready for the concert. The concert starts at, what time does the concert start, Naomi? Yeah, the concert starts at 6:30, so we gonna get ready and shit way before then, and then because I want to take pictures or whatnot. And yeah, and y'all, I didn't even know that Arizona had a Whataburger. So like, Arizona has a Whataburger. I didn't even know that. You know, I told Aulé this morning. I said, yeah, we went to Whataburger. She was like, whoa, Arizona has a Whataburger? Yeah. So I was like, yeah. She was like, wow. She's like, Whataburger is actually expanding. Yeah, they had a Whataburger and their food was good. Well, I didn't eat my burger. I just ate my burger right now. Guys, when I tell y'all I was tired. So I had my fries in the car. Bro, the fries were so fresh. Like, my burger was good right now that I just ate. I do think, though, it would have been better last night. Yeah, my burger would have been better. See, I was supposed to eat my burger, y'all, but I took a nap and Naomi did not wake me up. Okay. She just let me sleep. Like, I don't know why she would do something like that. Okay. Not a good friend. I'll wake you up tonight. She's not a good friend. But yeah. I'll wake you up. Yeah. So anyways, vlog. Anyways, vlog. I'm talking to the vlog. I'm not talking to somebody over there. Anyways, vlog. Oh, bro, see, I have some of the most disruptive friends ever. You ready?
What?
Do
you think I was there playing?
Fuck you. I'm not ready. I just need to put on my dress though and brush my teeth. All right, y'all, let me go put on my dress and brush my teeth, and then we gonna be out.
Stop, bro. Get the pins. No. Stop. Bro.
promise you I'm gonna hit a pin.
Don't miss it. This ain't all that. I hope you get it. Oh, it didn't work.
Shut up.
It didn't work.
Dory, just Dory. All
right, she's gonna go, y'all. Hold on, hold on, Naomi. Let me record you.
Okay.
What's your trick?
My trick is, I can't tell y'all, so if you want.
So we about to play another game, and when I win again, we're gonna come back and talk about it again, okay? She said that she didn't know this drink was gonna be.
I don't know what the dude is to me. What is it doing?
What is the drink doing to you?
It's doing everything. I don't know.
You didn't know the drink was gonna do this?
I didn't know. The drink tastes too good to do this. Why is it doing this?
Y'all, she didn't know the drink was gonna be strong, and now she's drunk.
I really did not.
Mind you, she's the fucking driver. she didn't know it was gonna hit her like that. The bitch thought she was drinking juice. I'm taking your driving into consideration.
Yeah, my arms are open. I have natural skin. Because I didn't put on deodorant today.
You telling me?
I didn't put on deodorant.
I'm hurting, guess I'm jaded. Most of these things I don't wanna say. I wanna be around while you're chasing. You wanna hit me up when you make it. You'll try and come back when you're famous. I always want the truth, but it's dangerous. You got something real, not basic. You wanna get with me, stop. Yes, I'm hurting, guess I'm jaded. Most of these things I don't want to say.
Let me get the camera for y'all. This is the ending of the vlog. I am currently in the airport right now. I'm waiting for my flight. My flight is at, let me see. My flight is at 12, well, we leave at 12:55 and it's 11:55 right now, so. What I'm probably about to do right now is I filmed a story time for you guys, and the story time should be out already. Well, it's a subscriber story time. It should be, the story time is definitely going to be out before this video. And I filmed the story time, like, oh, I don't know when I filmed it, but I'm about to take out my camera and I'm about to see if I could try to get some editing in real quick before I get on the plane. So behind, I have a lot of stuff to do. When I get home, I have to pack and I have to move out of my campus apartments, because you know I'm done. I'm not in school no more. So I got to pack as soon as I get home. I'm landing at 5 o'clock. Y'all already, well, if you guys do not know, Phoenix is 2 hours behind. So my plane lands, it's going to be 5 by the time I land in Houston. And that's annoying because now I'm stuck in, and if something's in my eye, my bad, y'all. I still have hair from my lashes, but yeah, y'all already know. Well, if y'all don't know, that 5 o'clock traffic about to hit me like a mug. If you guys enjoyed this vlog, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. I know I did not record as much as like I usually record with my like out of trip vlogs, but like this was one of them little, like, you know, just little getaways from reality. And oh, well, let me tell you guys how I like Arizona. Arizona is such a pretty state. They're so clean. Like, all jokes aside, like, if y'all been to Texas, y'all know Texas ain't clean, okay? The roads be dirty, concrete on the floor. Like, Texas is very gutter, you know? And you know, the thing is, I don't blame Texas. I think it's the fact that a lot of people live in Texas more than they live in Arizona. And like, it's so much going on. Like, you know, like, Houston, we don't sleep, you know, like, and then there's so many people in Houston, so I'm not surprised that Houston is dirty. But just coming to Arizona and seeing Arizona, I was just like, yeah, like, Arizona's so clean, it's so beautiful. Like, the buildings are nice, the house, like, everything just looks perfect over here. It do get hot over here, like, it get really, really hot, but like, I like this heat. The type of heat that Arizona has is the type of heat that you gonna be hot, but you ain't, it ain't gonna be to the point where your whole lace is lifting and, you know, you struggling to, like, it's not gonna be that type of hot. Like, it's just hot. Cause you know, when it get hot in Texas, you might as well say goodbye to your lace. Your makeup, oh, you did that in the morning? Your clothes, sweaty. Everything, bye. But like in Arizona, it was hot. There were plenty of times, like when we did the saltwater tubing, it was hot as fuck. Like, the sun was sitting on my face. I did not sweat. I was barely sweating. My armpits weren't sweaty. Like, if, can you believe, like, there's no way in hell that I'm gonna be doing the salt river tubing in Texas and I'm not gonna be sweating and my lace ain't gonna be lifting. And y'all, look at my lace. Now, the hair looks a little crusty. This got installed days ago. But look, if this was Houston, bro, I would have been wearing a hat right now or something, because the lace would have not even been presentable at all. That's what I like about the heat. The people, they're cool. I didn't really interact with the people as much, but they cool. They don't give me vibes that they be bothering it. I feel like everyone just mind their own business out here and do their own thing. Cause I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. When I went to Vegas, I was about to slap some white people in their face cause they kept staring. It's like they were staring on some, like, why is she free? Like, why is she not picking my cotton? Like, that's the way they were staring in Vegas, bro. But out here, like, everybody just mind their business. So I like that. I am gonna be traveling again in like 2 more weeks. So, and I ain't gonna tell y'all, it's a surprise. But I'm actually gonna really, really vlog that because I'm going out of the country. So I definitely like to have my out of the country trips really, really long and detailed and everything.
This is a boarding call for San Diego passengers Ernest Kelly and Chris Maple on flight 224. We are fully boarded.
Yeah, shut up. No, I'm just kidding. But something's wrong with me. But yeah, y'all, I like you guys so much. Not I like you guys, I like you. No, I love you guys so much. If you guys are new to the channel, be sure to check out the rest of the videos. And if you do like the videos, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, if you guys are already subscribed to my channel, check out my socials. They're in the description box down below. And if you guys do not know, my name is Irene. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.